Well, I'm just sitting here at the eye doctor's office waiting for my wife to come out. She's getting her eyes checked. She had laser surgery, so they just checking to be sure that the surgery actually took and is still holding where it's supposed to be. It shouldn't take too long. Last time she was only in there for like 15 minutes, and it's been 5 minutes this time. So just wait for her to come back out, then we'll probably go get something to eat and then head back home. It's Valentine's Day. Our youngest daughter and her boyfriend has taken the car and spending the day together, which is a nice day to be out and about. Then they're gonna go see like a 3 o'clock in the afternoon movie, and then they're gonna come home and sit there with our son and watch movies and eat pizza. And then while they're doing that, me and my wife is gonna go out and get something to eat and go see a movie and whatnot. Have no idea what movie or what where we're gonna go eat, but we'll be somewhere. But today I have no work because I took no calls for today. I got one for tomorrow, but I don't have nothing for today because when people say, can you come Tuesday? Nope. Got the day off. That's the advantage of having your own business. You can choose the days that you want off and spend time with the ones that you're supposed to spend time with. That's how you make friendship. That's how you make a marriage work. Not get married, work from sun up to sundown, 7 days a week, never get to see each other, never get to go out to a movie but once a year. That's not a marriage. And that's one of the reasons, many of the reasons why marriages divorce rate is so high in the United States. Because people says their vows, but they don't do what they're supposed to do to make the marriage work. And then they try to blame, well, I have to work all the time, or I have to do this. Well, no, you don't. Your marriage comes first. Both parties of the marriage does not have to work. You do not have to work from sun up to sun down. That's just like people say, well, I can't find a job in this town. You can go in any town and find a job. They just don't want to drop their pride and go work somewhere else that's not in the field that they have their education on, just to be able to pay their bills. Now, if you're trying to find a job in a certain field, like medical field, and a certain, you know, being a registered nurse or anything like that, yeah, you might have a problem finding that kind of job in that particular town. But you can't go around and say you cannot find a job. There's a job in every town if you're willing to work. Get a job, regardless if it's in your field, line of field of work or not, just to pay your freaking bills. Don't depend on other people to take care of your freaking bills. Man up, woman up, or whatever, and do what you're supposed to do. Go out there and work and pay your own bills. I don't feel sorry for them people at all. And if I hear anybody say that, say, oh, I can't find a job, I lay all in on them and tell them how I feel. And I tell them, I can get you five jobs before the end of the week. And one of them took me up on the offer, and I did not get him 5 jobs in a week. I got him 8 jobs in that week. Some people just not willing to work. They come up with all the lamest excuses to not to work. They work harder of coming up with excuses than they would to actually go get a freaking daggone job. Stupid. That's about like I've been seeing online, people making stupid statements like majority of the United States hates Trump. Well, I'm sorry, but the majority proves that majority likes Trump because that's how he got to be the president. That's how voting works. The majority wins. Some people just don't have no common sense. Make that statement before he comes president, it would make sense. But after he comes president and say majority of people hate him and would not vote for him, well, I'm sorry, you're wrong. Majority wins. That's what's voting for. This world is so screwed up. People just don't use common sense. A lot of people say, that don't line up with logic. It don't line up with science. Well, it lines up with common sense. Science is not always right. They have their theories, but that's all they are, is theories. No way to prove them. But I ain't going to get on a rampage about that because I have to make a whole new channel for that. Then some people are just so closed-minded and use idiotic ways of thinking and think it's true and fact. And they use that as a scapegoat to get their way and try to make themselves look better, make themselves feel better, or a excuse so they don't have to do anything. Well, at the end, they'll realize they were wrong. They probably already know they're wrong. They just don't want to admit it. They just make excuses so they don't have to do nothing. Well, they're the ones that's going to be left out in the boat with no paddle, and there's a hole in it. So let them live their lives. Hopefully they can swim, because they're going to have to learn to swim eventually. And longer they wait, longer the swim is. Swimming to shore when you can still see the shore is a lot easier than when you're out there and you don't see no land nowhere. So that's their life. But it's been 8 minutes or so since I've been doing this, so that means it's been almost 15 minutes or so since she's been in there. So I'm just waiting for her to come out, so it might be busy because the parking lot seems to be more filled up this time than last time we got here. And I got an appointment tomorrow morning to go to the dentist to get my teeth checked and all that good stuff. Got to keep them all straight and in order and nice and bright and white and all that good stuff. Like I said in my video, I don't eat junk food, fast food, sweets and stuff like that. I just don't eat that much of it. I don't even drink sodas. I quit drinking sodas, God, 18 years ago. I drink water or I drink coffee. Basically, coffee is water. And I don't drink alcohol except maybe a glass of wine. I would say probably, let's see, 1 glass of wine, maybe 2, maybe a year, and maybe five or six wine coolers through the whole year. That's it. That's all I drink. And it's on a special occasion, like if my wife and I will go out to eat, have a nice steak dinner, or when we go over to her mother's house for Christmas, we drink a half a glass of wine. Other than that, that's the only alcohol that I actually consume through the whole year. Pretty much a six pack of wine coolers and a glass of half a glass of wine. That's it. I don't have time for that. And beer, God, I haven't found a beer that I have any desire to taste or drink. I just don't have time to be drinking and really any kind of alcohol. It's just not worth it. Who wants to get drunk and get up in the next morning and don't remember what all happened the night before? That's stupid. Most people drink, they're trying to be blending in with a group, or they got so much problems in their life, they're trying to drink it away so they can just forget all about it temporarily until next morning and it's all back. That's no life to live. But my wife is heading back this way. I see her coming out the door. So we're gonna go get something to eat. Probably pick it up and go back home because nobody's home right now. Our daughter's gone with her boyfriend. They'll be gone until probably about 4:30 or so, whenever the movie's over. And our son will not be home from school until 4:15. So we have the house to ourselves until then. And we sat up until 4 or 5 o'clock this morning, and here it is 9:30. So we hadn't got too much sleep. So I'll probably go home, eat breakfast, and crawl back in bed. A good way to spend Valentine's Day, in bed, asleep, curled up to your wife. And then wake up, take a shower, and then go take your wife out to dinner and to a movie. And don't think about work at all. Now, of course, I know I'll probably go in there and get maybe 3 hours of sleep and I'll wake up because I have my 6 hours in. When I get 6 hours of sleep, usually I'm wide awake then. Then I'll go into the studio and fire up the studio lights, fire up the computer, and crank out some videos. So I'll see you when I see you. Well, I was gonna wait until I get back home in the studio and do some more of this vlog for the day, the Valentine vlog. But I saw something when we stopped here at Hardee's getting something to eat and take home that I just cannot believe that has happened. I cannot think of a reason why it has happened. It don't make sense. Today is Valentine's Day of 2017. That's February. And I'm sitting in a parking lot next to Hardee's, which is a parking lot of Pier 1 Imports, Books a Million, Office Depot, Hobby Lobby. And I turn and look at one of their light poles. And guess what I see? Yep, a good old Christmas wreath. And the thing is, that's not the only one. I don't know if this is going to work, but I'm going to try to zoom in one that I see here as well. If you zoom in right there, and one of them poles over there further back that direction has one as well. There's three. Matter of fact, there's one right there. One right there. And one on that pole way back there. There's three that I see. I don't understand why they still have it up. I think they had enough time to take it off the pole. And the funny thing is, that really makes it questionable, is there's other poles in here that they had the same decoration on. So why take some of them down and leave three of them up? It don't make sense why they still have three still on the pole. Leave your comments below what you think about them leaving the Christmas wreaths on the light poles. Well, we are here paying our internet bill at Time Warner Cable, which is Spectrum now. They just hadn't changed over all the signs and everything. Then we move on to paying the van payment. Go pay car van insurance. That's all needed to be paid today, so we're going to pay them and get back home so I can do some more videos. All right, we are here making the van payment, or the loan payment, that where we refinanced the van to get a lower rate, lower payments, and a shorter time to pay it off, which is at One Main Financial. And plus they put a little bit of cash in our pocket at the same time, so that was nice. And then we'd be off and paying the insurance, the business insurance. And then we'd be heading home. All right, now we are at my insurance company paying another bill. All the bills that are due before the 15th, I like to wait about to the 13th and 14th and just pay all them bills, and then whatever's left, pay on the last day of the month. Now it's time to go home.
Well, we are back home. Sat and discussed where we want to go eat tonight for Valentine. And my wife has chosen Ruby Tuesday. I don't mind at all going to Ruby Tuesday because their salad bar is really good. They have hundreds of items on their salad bar. I mean, from one end, this is not even showing the whole salad bar here behind me. This is about half of the salad bar. It's at least probably somewhere around 18 feet long. They got different kinds of salad leaves. It's all kinds of stuff that you have in there. It's not just a regular salad bar. Yeah, you got your carrots and your onions and tomatoes, stuff like that, but they have the pineapple, mushrooms, green peas, sliced up ham. I mean, it's a meal of its own, and it's unlimited salad bar. I'll be eating that salad bar, and that's all I'll be eating. And see if I can get some video of that as well, because that would be part of today's vlog. So yeah, you'll see that in this vlog before, if you watch the rest of this vlog, you'll see the salad bar while we are there. Always try to eat healthy. But right now, I'm going to sit here and make a business video because I'm a little bit behind because today is Tuesday and I got to make a video for yesterday. So a little bit behind. I'll go ahead and get that made and get that posted. Don't know what I'm gonna make it of yet. I got still a list of things that I can make. So I gotta pick one, make the video, and upload it. So I am out of here for right now. And most likely, probably the next time I see you, I'll be standing in front of this salad bar here. So I'll see you there. Well, we are back now. It's a little just past midnight. It's 15 minutes past midnight. I'm gonna spend more time with my wife. We're gonna watch some TV. Got all the kids in bed. So I'm gonna get me a cup of coffee. Sit back with my wife and watch some movies. Then I will get some sleep, and then I have a doctor appointment in the morning at 8:40. And then there's no telling what I'm going to do for the rest of the day. I might check on the car because it has a water leak. It's been that way for over a year now, but it hadn't been leaking that much. But the weather's supposed to be warm, I do believe. Check tomorrow. I figured I'd go ahead and take this opportunity of free time if the weather's permitting to check the leak out and see if I can actually repair it. I know where it's at. Okay. For some reason, internet just dropped out. And I have no idea why. It's just dropped that internet. It says no internet access. Let's see if figure out why. Can troubleshoot and see if it's just lost connection to the router or is it actually no internet at all. I don't have my phone to check the wireless. Says it's looking for problems in the web. Connectivity. Looking for problems in name collision. So it's scanning different things and see what it can find. Right now, I have no internet here. I don't know My cat's got hold of a cord and wanted to chew on it or not. But I just had internet. And cats were not messing with the wires or anything. So, I don't think that's going to be it. It says, your broadband modem is experiencing connection issue. It says, unplug and turn off the modem. After all lights on the modem are off, wait at least 10 seconds. Turn the modem on and plug it back into the power outlet. So, let me go do that. Let me go check the lights on the cable modem. So it might not be anything in-house. It might actually be them working actually on the service for some reason. But let me go check that and I'll be right back. Well, I went and checked it out and found out that the cable modem was not communicating with the internet provider. So I unplugged it, plugged it back in, it reset itself, then I reset my router, and it connected to the modem. Now I got internet once again. For some reason it dropped out, and I don't have no idea why. They might be working on the service for some reason, and I just had to reset the modem on my end. It happens time to time, maybe once or twice a month. And it's always somewhere between 12 midnight and 6 in the morning. Sometimes I get up in the morning and I have no internet, but when I went to bed, I had internet. So I just go unplug everything, leave it off for about 5 minutes, plug the modem in, as soon as it connects, then I plug in the router, then it connects to the modem, and all lights turn green, and everything's fine. Usually I can unplug it, let all the lights go off, plug in the modem. As soon as it boots up, I go make coffee while it's booting up. Then I come back, and it's already booted up when I prepped the coffee. And then I turn on the router, and by the time I could get the coffee that's been made, all up and running before I even get to the computer and turn it on in the morning. So, no big deal. But I'm going to end the vlog here, and I'm going to watch some TV now that we got internet back, because we do not have cable TV at all. We get all our channels, somewhere around a little bit over 3,000 channels that we have, over internet. Don't have internet. We have no channels except over the antenna, which we have about 20 to 23 local TV channels that we can watch. So I'm going to end the vlog here. Like always, do something today that will move you up to that next level. And I'll see you on the next one.